Rogers.
Hell yeah.
Hey, Patty, can I get as much guitar and vocals in this little configuration as I can? So, I think we're at a divergent point in history in the Western world especially. We're going to decide what the next 100 years looks like for the people that come after us, and you should really care about that, because your misery is not something that you should defer on to further generations. That's what the fucking baby boomers did. Fuck that shit. We have to care about the people that follow after us. But, you know, whatever you believe in, you've got to get out there and you've got to fucking fight for it in the streets. I mean that literally. But I don't mean it. I don't mean it in the way of arms. It's non-violent non-compliance. If there's any part of Make America Great Again, fuck that shit, first of all. If it's any part of great American history, it's the civil rights movement where people became non-violent, non-compliant. They took up space. They took up the money that was going to be flowing into these businesses, and they hit them where it hurts, which is their pocketbooks. So we got to fucking start doing this stuff. We got to start actually becoming activists again to fight for the fucking future, because it absolutely matters. And that's what this song is all about. It's called Balaclava Kiss. I do not understand how you people deal with the cold. It is ridiculous. I am, like half of us live in Georgia, and Angelica lives in LA or near LA, and it's like, coming here is like just being beaten by the fucking cold. But in any case, so this next song was on our first record, and it's one of the first songs we wrote. And it means a lot to me because approximately 10 years ago, I was still in the fucking army, which is a very different life from this. But I was in Afghanistan, and I was on the final combat deployment of that war. And I had a lot of feelings about that war, you know, even before I got there. And I realized the reality of that war when I got there. And that's the same as every fucking war, is that it's old men that can't agree, and they fucking send young men and women to die, fight, and kill for fucking nothing. But with, you know, I realized something there. It's like, without the Taliban, you know, because I want to make something very clear. Fuck the Taliban, and fuck anybody that uses their religion to tell you how you can and cannot live your life. Fuck those motherfuckers.
Fuck them! So,
without them, you know, women and femme-presenting people especially had a future. But because we lied to them, we told them, hey, we're going to stick with you, we're going to, you know, build stability, we're going to build infrastructure, but we lied to them, because that's what happens when your wars are based on imperialism and colonial control. Maybe England knows a little bit about that, I don't know. But in any case, this song I always dedicate to people that are suffering in conflict zones, because it's not the fucking soldiers the most, it's not, it's for damn sure isn't the politicians, it's the civilians, it's the people that are caught in between all this struggle and strife. So whether it's that fucking horrific genocide that's happening in Gaza, or the one that's happening in Sudan, Congo, Myanmar, China, with the Uyghurs that nobody fucking talks about, these things are happening, and it's all because of these systems of military abuse. So we owe the world better by recognizing this shit and fucking stopping it once and for all. We need to fucking transcend this stuff. So this song is called Kandahar. So that's the next song. We'll be right back. you. This next song is about how time is not guaranteed. It is afforded by the universe. I spent a long time when I left the military as a firefighter and a paramedic in Atlanta. And it was arguably kind of more traumatic than the military because you see a lot of really awful ends to life. So I just hope that you know that every day is fucking precious. And I know that this world is really good at grinding you fucking down between social media and the fucking news and the horrible things that we see every day on our phones and all shit. Just remember that it is a good thing that you're here. And we need to appreciate and value this time. So this song is called Beautiful Day Today. It's like more intimate shows, so this is fun. So when I left the military because I was like, fuck that. Like, I don't ever want to do anything that involves like hurting another fucking person, whether directly or indirectly. So, you know, I became a firefighter and I was doing the thing, and I was really proud of the work that we did because all the wonderful thing about being a firefighter and paramedic is all you fucking do is help people sit. There's no moral gray area. You're not like, how do we plug this gunshot wound? Is it going to make a difference? Is it going to be questionable? No, you just fucking do it. But, you know, for the longest time, I felt fine, like, dealing with all these, like, pretty horrid things in life and seeing a lot of really awful shit. And then there was this, like, one really bad call that I ran as a firefighter. So I do, like, both the fire engine and the ambulance. And, like, I witnessed some people burning to death, and it was fucking truly awful. It really, like, affected me in a way that I, like, recognized that, like, oh shit, like, there's nothing, like, everything after this day is gonna be different, you know? It's like one of those things. And shortly thereafter, I got diagnosed with PTSD, and I was like, oh, fucking no wonder, right? But the thing that, you know, I did all the things I was supposed to do. I, like, talked to a doctor, I got medicated, went to therapy, and it made a fucking difference. And if you listen to anything that I say tonight, I want you to take this to heart. If you're going through anything mental health-wise, you have to fucking take an active effort in getting better. You're not just going to get better. You have to care about and love yourself. But the thing I didn't understand is, like, getting better, it's not just getting better. It's peaks and valleys, right? It's like ups and downs. And when I get into those low places, even now, like, all the fucking time, I still have this thing. And it feels like this shadow self over my shoulder, and it says, hey, you've done the thing, you've done the therapy, you've done the medication, you're still working, and it's not fucking working. Fuck that shit, fuck that voice, fuck all of that. Don't ever fucking listen to that shit, okay? You've got to fight for yourself, and that's absolutely what this song is about. It's called Stay. Yeah. Scottish bastard over there. That's the spicy one. Oh, fucking hell. It's good to be back in the land of good whiskey. Americans call it bourbon. It's trash. It's fucking swill. Don't drink that shit. Now that I've bummed out the room full of people wearing black shit, back home in Athens, Georgia, I DJ like a local goth night. It's called Athens Goth Night, whenever there's a lull and I want to bring it back up, there's one song I always play, because I know that everybody knows the words. Are there any Cure fans?
Yeah! Yeah!
No way. No fucking way. Indulge us, if you know the words, sing along. I know it's Tuesday, but let's fucking have some fun, because life is too short not to, right? We'll be right back. Smith, wonderful little song. He wrote that shit about his wife Mary Poole like 35 years ago or 40 years ago, and he is still like crazy in love with her. Like, come look this shit up, it's insane. So, you know, who said that the gods can't be cute? They can be. We can have a good time. Let's get back to the depressing shit, I guess. This song is all about falling in love with things that are bad for you. Don't do it.
I'm not afraid to
That was just a cup of vodka. Nah, some water. We got a couple more.
Yay!
I assume that like most of you are fucking miscreants because you're out on a Tuesday and that's my kind of people. We got some thank yous though. Thanks to Patty for fucking great sound tonight. Everybody. Sound engineers work so hard and they get no accolades. So give it up one more time. Thank you to the quarry for having us here. It's a fucking great place. Thank you also to the Nightmares, our fucking good friends. Make sure you buy some merch from them because you want them to come back, right? So that helps them come back to your town, buy some merch. We also have merch with Debbie over here. Debbie is standing by to take your call for merchandise at 1-800. Buy my shit. Really, and the biggest thank you is to y'all for being here. Tuesday night is the first time we've ever been here, and it's fucking amazing. We'll be back for sure. All right. Are there any cat people here?
Yes!
Okay. All right, so here's the deal. I'm going to play a song to you that I wrote as a joke on the internet a long time ago. And a lot of people got really upset about it. And it's not a political song at all, actually. It's just a song that is a mere list of things that cats are not. It is a fact. They are not these things. Any associations that you might make are your own. So, anyway, here's a fucking song about cats. Let's fucking dance. We got a couple more songs. Tuesday fucking night, Liverpool. We gotta feel the heat. We gotta get that energy up because it's cold as fuck and I wanna be like hot as fuck when I'm outside. So let's have a good time. Let's dance together. What do you say? We'll be right back. cardinal sin to play two cover songs in one set, but I just checked and I don't fucking care. This is, I'm a bit of an Anglophile when it comes to music. All my favorite music came from depressed old British men. It's because there's no fucking sun here. What the fuck did you do with this shit? But in any case, this is like, I think there's this amazing thing that happens with music where you hear music and you don't need to know anything about the band. You just hear fucking notes and you say, that's the thing. That's the sound, right?
So it's
open, and I heard that when I was 13 when I heard this song and this band, a little band from Manchester called Joy Division. Song, I think the song is all about losing yourself to music. So let's fucking do that right now. Let's do it. Let's just have a good time and let's dance, dance, dance. Song, right? I know some of you need the theater, because you're English after all. So we'll simulate the encore performance. Thank you, Liverpool. You've been wonderful. We'll see you next time. You're such a gracious audience, and I appreciate it. Okay, so this last little bit. Make sure you tip your bartenders and be nice to the staff, and don't fucking drink and drive and get home safe and all these things. With this last little song, I'm going to give you the words to the chorus, because it's very simple, and why don't you sing along with me? Because it's Tuesday, and we're all fucking drunk and miscreants. The words are very simple. I can feel your knife in my back. I can feel your knife in my side. You will figure out the melody. It is extraordinarily simple because I wrote it. Liverpool, are you ready for the fucking song?
Bullshit, are you ready for one more fucking song? Watch for.
Filthy Ladies, hey!
One more.
Then you can
Broken, love you, bastards! Broken fingers!
Here's the deal. I'm losing my voice.
One more, then you can go.
So we'll do one more, right? But when we're gonna hang out for a bit, we're gonna do the merch thing and all that stuff. I'm glad to take pictures. I'm gonna be really deadly silent. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Because I've fucking talked enough. Jesus, you know, some of you are like, shut the fuck up. But one more song. Yeah.
Broken fingers.
Alright, one more song. This is a new one. This one, Living Dead.
Thank you. Angelica. And of course, Ryan Houches, the fucking animal on the screen. One last time for the Nightmares over here. Check out the next week. And really, thank you for being here. I got one last little thing to say, and then I promise I finally will shut the fuck up. Look, I was born back in the way, way back time of the fucking 1980s, which for some of you is like, wow, you're old as shit. And some of you are like, dude, shut the fuck up. But I was born in Berlin, right? And in that time we had the wall, and the wall split not just east and west of Berlin, but east and west of the world. And on the east side of that wall lived people under what was called the DDR, and they were under a really oppressive authoritative state. But you see, as it turns out, maybe our fucking politicians should take heed. In both of our countries, walls don't stop a fucking thing. They don't stop shit. And they definitely didn't stop radio waves in the late 70s and early 80s from bringing punk fucking rock music over across that wall. So these kids, some of them 18, 19 year olds, they start hearing bands like the Dead Kennedys and the Clash. But it wasn't an alien, a foreign message to them. It was their own story that they were hearing. And that message and that story is real fucking simple. And it still stands today. You are being fucked over. You are being divided and pitted against each other. The working classes of the world are being pitted against each other so a worldwide oligarchical elite can fucking operate with impunity and get away with the shit that they do in plain sight. So they said, fuck that, we're gonna fucking do this ourselves. So they started forming their own bands, and they made a lot of noise. And immediately those governments said, the DDR government, they said, fuck you, you're not gonna do this. You're subversive, you're divisive. And they started putting children in prison for playing music. But as it turns out, walls don't stop radio waves, and they definitely don't stop people from demanding their freedom. And those kids, they got up in places that probably looked a lot like this. On rougher edges of town, in industrial areas, wherever they could, and they fucking made enough noise, and they started getting political, and they started forming community, and they started learning each other's names. And when times got really hard, they leaned on each other, and eventually, they were very directly responsible for helping bring that fucking wall down and getting their freedom. So, I want to make it very clear to you why I'm giving you a history lesson on Tuesday night. We're in a divisive time, we're in a very weird time where we're gonna decide what the future looks like. But I don't know like how we fix a lot of the shit, but I do know one thing. This alternative subculture, goth, post-punk, punk, metal, all the shit, it fucking matters more yes. now than it ever has. So look around you, it's Tuesday night, literally look around you, it's a good crowd for a Tuesday night of a band that's never fucking been here before in my book. So learn each other's names, learn the community, build the shit, keep it fucking alive, because as things get harder, these are the people you're gonna lean on, I promise you. So keep your scene alive, and remember, above all else, until everybody in this whole fucking world is free, none of us are. We'll see you next time. Until then, stay strange.